live story time. Okay, so basically, hi, I am from Texas, and I know I don't sound like I'm from Texas, but I am, I promise. And basically, I was born at the worst. Can I have 5 minutes? I just started recording a video. Okay. Sorry, guys. Don't worry about that part. So I was born at the worst possible time. Want to know why? My parents have been lying to me my entire life. They say that my birthday is on the 17th of October. Yeah, sure. Yeah, totally. I was born at 12:12. 12 o'clock p.m. is the next day, mother. And they know that. And they know that they're lying. So I'm gonna try to confront her, but basically, like, I just don't know what to do. Because, like, who would know what to do to confront their mother that they're lying? Like, how would somebody be able to do that? 'Cause I would get in so much trouble. But I could just say, "Hey, Mom, I figured out something. We've been celebrating on the wrong day for my birthday." Hopefully, she would say, like, something like, "How is that, honey?" And then I could explain to her, but probably not gonna happen. So I'm taking my hair ties off. Okay, and basically, I FaceTimed my aunt and was like, "Hey, Auntie, I need some help with this." And she's like, "Oh, well, I don't think I can help you 'cause I've never had to deal with this problem. So goodbye." And then she hung up. Like, I don't like my that aunt, 'cause she's just rude to me. And she has dealt with that problem before. Her birthday is on the 18th of December, and they were celebrating on the 17th of December. So, yeah. So basically, I was like, "Oh my gosh, what am I gonna do?" And then I decided, "Oh, I'm gonna call my best friend because she will hopefully know how to help me." She didn't. She was just like, "Oh, I'm so sorry that your mom has been lying to you your whole life and that she knew that she was. And, like, I am just so sorry, but I gotta go to dinner now." And I was like, "Oh, that's okay. I have Jalen to call." And she was like, "Oh, okay. Bye. Love you." And I was like, "Bye. Love you." So then I called Jalen and slash Jaybird Squad. And also, the first person I called was Avery, my bestie. So then I called my other bestie, Jaybird Squad slash Jalen. And she's like, "Oh my gosh, here's what you should do to confront her." So this is just what she said. "Hey, Mom, I can't believe you. You have been lying to me my entire life. I can't believe that you lied to me about my birthday. You are such a mean person, and I never want to see you again. And I was like, but bestie, I mean, I love you and all, but that's a little harsh. And she was like, I mean, yeah, it's harsh, but it would get the problem over with. And I was like, bestie, I love you and all, but I'm gonna get a spanking. Lol. And also, this is a fake story because I'm not from Texas. And basically, I was like, so she was like, okay, well, then find your own way to confess to her. And I was like, wow, thanks a lot for your help. And at the time, Marin was on a trip, so I couldn't call her, sadly. Her channel's name is Mare Bear World, Mare Bear's World. So if you want to go check that out, go ahead after this video. And she was like, so I texted Jalen. I was like, you're such a great friend, Jay. You were being so rude to me when we were on call. What? I'm almost done. Sorry. And basically, you were just being really rude to me at the time, and I didn't know what to say. So, obviously, I was mad at her, and I didn't talk to her for the rest of the day. And she was sad because I didn't talk to her, but she has to get over it because it's not my fault she was the one that was rude. And so, yeah, and then I texted my best friend Avery again, and I was like, Jalen's just being really rude to me, and I don't know what to tell her because, literally, she was so being so rude to me. She was literally like, well, that's too bad. Then don't ask me for help when you need help. And Avery responded, and she was like, oh, Jalen, she is so rude. Also, guys, remember, this is a fake story. Well, it's not a fake story. It's a dream. And if you see this video, I'm not calling you a real mean meanie weenie. You are one of the nicest people I know. So don't worry, I'm not actually calling you rude. And neither is Avery. Okay, back to the story. And I was like, right? And then Avery said, maybe you should apologize to her. And I was like, why me? And she was like, because, I mean, you were kind of being rude from what you said. And I was like, now both of my friends are being mean to me. Best friends are being mean to me. And Avery was like, how am I being rude to you? And I was like, because you're telling me to go apologize to somebody who was rude to me. And she was like, "Ugh, you're so annoying." And she meant to send that to her sister because, you know, they play around. And I was like, "Wow, you're such a great friend," sarcastically. And she was like, "Oh, shoot, I meant to send that to my sister." And I was like, "Yeah, right." And she literally sent me a screenshot. And I was like, "That's edited. Oh my God, guys, look how sparkly my fingies are." Okay, anyways. And like, I didn't believe her and I said they were edited and all that stuff. So basically after that, things went downhill from there. So Jalen responded and I didn't text her back. I just looked at what she said and she was like, "You're the one being rude now, but I guess I'm sorry for saying that." And I was like, and I, since I didn't respond to her, I was like, in my mind, I was like, whatever. I still don't forgive her. Not until at least tomorrow. Not until at least next week, actually. 'Cause like, obviously you would be mad at the person who was mean to you. Hold on, guys. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. Sorry, guys, I was talking to my parents. So basically, eventually I responded and I was like, "I'm sorry too. I'm literally crying right now because I didn't actually mean that and I miss you so much and I love you. And you're the best person that could happen to me other than Avery. And you are my best friend and I just love you so much." And she was like, "Oh, I love you too. But do you forgive me?" And I'm like, "Did you not read the text?" And she was like, "Oh, so now you're back to being rude." And I was like, "I'm sorry, okay? But I literally said, I forgive you and I'm sorry in the text." So, like, I'm not trying to be rude, but that's literally what I said. And then I went to our group chat slash GC, and I was like, "I'm sorry, okay, Jalen? I'm sorry, 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 sorry." And I went to the group chat so Avery could back me up with this whole conversation. And Jalen was like, "Well, you were rude when it was just us texting again. So, no, I don't forgive you." And then Avery came into the chat and was like, "Jalen, she said she's sorry. Now, please just forgive her so I can be over with this." And Jalen was like, "No." And we were on call. So, yeah. And obviously, I didn't want to be in a fight, and I was like, "Avery, can you leave and then join in a second, so I can talk to Jalen privately?" And Avery was like, "Here, I'll just mute and turn my video off." And I was like, "Fine." And basically, I was like, "I'm sorry, Jalen. I'm sorry, okay? You can hate me as much as you want, but I'm sorry and I love you so much and I will do anything for your forgiveness. But if you don't want to forgive me, then Oh well, because I was the one being rude to my best friend. And she was like, I'll have to think about it. And Avery was like, Ava, she didn't say that. She was like, Ava, please mute and turn your video off. And I was like, fine. So I did, and Avery was like, Jayla, please just forgive her. She texted me and was like, I'm so, she, this is what she said. I wanna forgive Jalen, but like, cause she's my best friend and I love her so much. But I was being rude to her and I'm scared that she doesn't wanna be my friend anymore. She came to me and was like, can you please tell her that I forgive her? And this is Avery talking. And so then she said, and I love you, and all of your friends love you so much. Even Naren, even when we get into big fights, I still love you so much. And I never want to be without you in my entire life. And Jalen was like, no, I'm not forgiving her until she says she's sorry. And I unmuted and turned my video back on. I was like, excuse me, I just said I'm sorry 7,000,000 freaking times. And now you want to be rude to me? And I said sorry 7 times in the text. I said 7 billion times on call. I tried to call you 6,000,000 times. I call you every day, and now this is how you treat me, like trash. You are such a fake friend, Jalen. Such a fake friend. Not in real life, I promise. I know it sounded like I was talking about real life, but you are not. I mean, I know we get into a lot of arguments, but that doesn't mean that you're toxic. Anyways, so basically, after that, she was like, oh, here we go again with the rudeness and the blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, okay, well, now you're just being rude. And Avery agreed with me because she said, blah, 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 blah. Like, excuse me, I just apologized like 6 million times, and now you're saying blah 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 to me? No. You're acting toxic. That's literally what I said. And was like, oh, well, now you're the one being rude. And I was like, yeah, because you're being toxic. And I'm literally starting to cry. And Avery ends the call and calls me privately and is like, are you okay? I saw you starting to tear up. And I'm like, yeah, I guess. But she was my best friend before she introduced me to you. And now she's betraying me and being toxic. Like, what the actual heck? Why would she be toxic? And she was like, I don't know, but for some reason, she's either mad or she just doesn't want to be in the argument anymore and doesn't know how to end it. I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'm back. And basically, she was like, I don't know why she would be so toxic to you. She was literally your best friend when you were like 7. And like, what the actual heck? Like, why would she be so toxic to you? And I was like, right? Like, and then she was like, And this is what Avery said. Maybe you should call her and try apologizing again. And I was like, fine. Last time, and if she doesn't take the forgiveness and the apology, I'm not talking to her until she apologizes and forgets about this fight. And Avery was like, fine, that's fair. And basically, I called her and was like, but she didn't answer. She denied the call. And I was like, ugh. So I called Avery back and she was like, how did it go? And I didn't respond and I just added Jalen and she didn't see my user. So she just accepted the thing because she thought it was Avery calling and was like, ugh, Avery, what are you doing here? And I was like, I was the one that added you. I wanted to say I'm sorry, and if you don't forget this, I'm not gonna talk to you until you forget about this. So you either take my apology or we're not talking for the rest of the day. Or until you forget about it. And she was like, okay, I really am sorry and I forgive you, but this fight all happened because your mom was lying to you about your birthday. Like, excuse me? Okay. And basically, we were all friends again, and Marin finally got home from her trip, and we all lived happily ever after. Kind of. Not really, but kind of. And yeah. I hope you enjoyed this story. If you did, give it. I'm ending the video now. If you did, give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Bye. Love you. See you tomorrow.